I'm here with Sandy in the NVE Application Center. Sandy, can you explain how NVE's award-winning IsoLoop Isolators work?
I'd love to. But first, let's look at optocouplers. As this shows, optocouplers transmit signals by light through a dielectric that provides galvanic isolation. The optical elements are slowed, have limited life, and limit size.
I hate optos.
Doesn't everyone? But IsoLoop couplers use spintronics and magnetics, rather than optics, to transmit data. They consist of spintronic, GMR resistors, microscopic integrated coils, and conditioning electronics. The GMR resistors are spin valves, with two stable resistance states. A dielectric provides isolation. The coil creates a magnetic field, proportional to the input current. The field changes the spin polarization of the spin valves, which changes their resistance. The output is amplified and conditioned to produce an isolated replica of the input.
So, IsoLoops transmit signals by magnetic field and electron spin, rather than light and photons.
Exactly. And because ground potential variations are common to both sides of the coil, they don't generate a current. This yields a large common mode rejection ratio and true galvanic isolation.
Cool. And you said they were smaller and faster?
Darn right. IsoLoops are available in MSOPs, narrow and wide SOICs, plus PDIPs, with up to 5 channels per device. They run up to 150 megabits per second and up to 125 degrees C.
Way cool. Where can I get datasheets or more info?
You can click to go to the isolator section of nve.com or call us at 800 GMR 7141 extension 4.